alligator. You see it? Right there? Look up there. See all those? Say alligator.
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 That's a baby.
That's a lot in it. Yes.
You want to take a picture with it?
I'm half scared to go in there. Why, Chris? You saw me dying?
I was scared of her, I scared you.
It's not
not real.
Mama, look.
And you see her veil put like.
Look, mama. Look. Look, the veil. Look, it's not real.
Oh, you gonna sit down,
big
girl?
Oh.
Okay, baby.
Okay. Yay. Okay.
Yeah. Bitches, who we looking at?
I'm recording.
Not even looking though.
I'm still good, getting good pictures of y'all. Now, what you gonna take one with your mom?
Oh, he's chilling, chilling. Sorry, his kids out here. I think so. Somebody walking in, tell me what's inside. Oh, it's just more lemurs. Iguana. It's in the corner.
Mommy, look here. Mama, daddy, there's an iguana.
Oh, they really from in.
Get into the pool.
Baby, you
by force of 2100, and that does bite through concrete. The Nile crocodile walks around with a bite force of around 5,000. So I have no idea why they have evolved to have a bite force of over 5,000, but I reckon whatever reason they had to evolve, they're handling it okay. Now with that, this is my last piece of chicken. So if you guys haven't got any pictures done, I'm gonna try to get one more guy to jump. Reed, how are you doing over there? You're pretty low. One more piece as well, Evan. Last piece. So everyone's on their last piece. We're each gonna try to get a jump before you guys sum it up on finale. I'm gonna try to get this big guy here. See if I can get him out of the water one more time for us.
Wow.
Yeah. There we go. And he caught the chicken that time. Alright, awesome. That was my last piece by nature. And we do happen to have around 700 alligators here. So how do we deal with this cannibalistic nature? Well, first of all, we make sure all of our alligators are well fed. So they have no reason to pick on each other. But another thing that we do is we do take advantage of that opportunistic eater trait. So when I said they're looking for an easy opportunity, that basically means that they are lazy. They do not want to work very hard for their meals. They want the easiest meal they can get. So since they are lazy, we like to separate our alligators by size here because they are not likely to mess with an alligator the same size as them because that's just too much effort. But if there is a smaller one there, they'll have no problem trying to make them in their meal. That is also the same reason we're able to have turtles in the exhibits with these guys. So these guys can break through that turtle shell, but it is going to require a little bit of effort. And why waste that effort breaking through that turtle shell when they know if they wait long enough, chickens just going to fall from the sky? So I mentioned a couple times that these guys do have very, very strong jaws, but just how strong are their jaws? Well, to give you guys an idea, they have a bite force of around 2,100 pounds per square inch. So I did not hear very many oohs or ahs, if any, when I said 2,100 pounds per square inch. And that's okay, because I have no idea what 2,100 pounds per square inch means either. So I don't really know what it means, but I do know what it can do. So that means that one of these guys can no problem bite through your femur in one bite, which is the hardest bone in the human body. And theoretically, they should have no problem crushing concrete with those.
Say it again.
Oh, I just came out to check on you.
Oh, you know what's wrong? $4.25. I got Nevada.
What am I trying? For real, it's the sea turtle. I got them right there, the big old one.